free video.
Money from the bucket run gets that. And if they don't get it, they just get it.
Yeah. All right.
We'll make it happen for you.
Okay, and if you guys... Thank you so much for doing this. I really appreciate it. Thanks, Mr. Bill.
Oh, you bet.
Appreciate it.
My pleasure.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the first annual Mr. PHS Pageant. I'm Macy Halverson.
Yeah, Ma!
And I'm Ryan Bush, and I'm your MC this evening.
Woo!
Tonight, we have 8 handsome young men duking it out for the prestigious title of Mr. PHS, along with a $100 cash prize. Before we get started, we will introduce the judges.
On the left, we have the guy with the nicest flowing nose, our computer teacher, Bob Hill. In the middle, we have Wade Tipley, our enthusiastic gov-to-gov leader. And on the right, we have the lovely Latin teacher, Mr. Mickelson.
The contestants will be judged in 4 categories: formal wear, talent, pickup line, and overall stage presence. The formal wear, talent, and pickup line categories will each be worth 10 points. Overall stage presence will be worth 20 for a total of 50 possible points.
4 contestants will be eliminated after the talent portion. 2 more will be eliminated after the pickup line competition. And with the final 2 contestants, we will have a bucket run with all the proceeds going to the Children's Miracle Network. Whichever contestant gets the most money in their bucket will have an extra 5 points added to their score.
Yeah.
To kick off the night, we will start with introductions and formal wear.
Welcome to the stage, our first contestant, Senior Alan Garcia. And his favorite food is tacos from his dad's restaurant, Giles at 366 South Pier Street, open from 11 to 2 and 5 to 10 Monday through Saturday.
In this corner, weighing in at 160 pounds, mainly skin and bones, is Murdoch Word. Murdoch enjoys short... Murdoch enjoys short, brisk walks to the fridge for Mountain Dew and Doritos. A perfect date for him is playing Call of Duty at 3 in the morning and not dealing with you. He also has a soft spot for cute puppies and clowns.
Thank you, Murdoch. Now let's welcome Junior Daniel Ellis to the stage. Daniel enjoys trap music and a good coffee among friends. Daniel's idea of a perfect date is a trip to the city with dinner in the bouncy castle in town.
Next is Senior Derek Whiteman. Derek's dream career. Whichever comes first. Derek says his favorite school lunch is the cookies, OMG. Derek's greatest accomplishment is asking Mariah to prom and her saying yes.
That is quite the accomplishment. Next we have Junior Vicente Ramirez. His first day is pointing lasers at planes, and he really enjoys LSU with his track teammates, which is long, slow distance. And Pennington's cat, who's 73 years old in cat years.
Welcome Senior Jim Barnett. His hobbies include rolling heavy balls down a wooden lane, doing math homework, and making rice and noodles. If he was in the zombie apocalypse, the first thing he would do is find the nearest Trump supporter. Jim's best feature is his kill-to-death ratio on Call of Duty.
Thank you, Jim. Next we have Senior Peter Sanchez. Peter's favorite color is green. Go Govs. Peter's dream date consists of doing calculus under the stars. If he could, he would apply the second fundamental theorem of calculus to everything. Ow.
Last, but definitely not least, is Senior Garrett Mascara. Garrett's best feature is a fax machine, and a shake weight. The first thing Garrett would do in case of a zombie apocalypse would be to join the Amish Mafia.
Thank you, boys. I mean, I know you were all a little bummed out there wasn't a swimsuit portion, but you all look dashing. Now let's move on to our talent competition. We have some fascinating talents for you guys tonight. First up, we have senior Alan Garcia dancing with sophomore Joanna Bannon.
People wonder who's next up. That conversation really ends here.
Sorry. If you could be any Kardashian sister, who would it be?
Caitlyn.
So we hear you like G-Eazy. Can you sing a little bit for us, like right now?
No. Oh my God, I can't do this.
What's one song that describes you?
Girls just want to have fun.
If you could fight one person in the world, who would it be?
Donald Trump. Sorry. Donald Trump.
What came first, the chicken or the egg?
The chicken. If you drop a chicken from heaven, it will survive. But if you drop an egg
First, I'm going to say them regularly for anyone who is not familiar with the alphabet. I believe it is 26 letters, and it is all in English. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. You can sing along if you want. H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, A, I, S, W, Y, and Z. Oh, my ABCs. Next time, sing with me. I don't remember the song. Here that was a while ago. All right, here we go. Hey, eyes up. They're a little lopsided. Z-Y-X-W-V-U-T-S R-U-F-M-R-U-R-U-P-O-N-M-L-K-J-I-H? I'm pretty sure that's G. F-E-D-C-B-A. Now I know my alphabet backwards. I was just looking at my poop.
Next, we have Junior Daniel Ellis dance battling with Murdoch.
Buy me like a mango.
Well, Macy, can I call you Macy? I think that I'm like a mango because I'm sweet, I'm tangy, and I'm very good with a side of salad dressing.
If you could fight one person in the world, who would it be?
Dwayne The Rock Johnson. No questions asked, I take him out by the knees. Obviously, I don't have the strength and running power as that man, but I think if I bit him a little bit down there, I think I could take him out.
If you could win gold in any event, what would it be?
Well, I'd like to think that it would be competitive brooming. So sweeping on the ground, I know my way around a broom pretty well, working after work once in a while, you know, sweep, 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 and all that jazz.
Yo, hang your butt! Before I do this, I'm about to call somebody out. Yo, Mr. Murdoch, you ready for this?
I'm
actually gonna drop the mic, these things are expensive.
Reforestation is what the scientists call it. That then we would have more oxygen and our brains would grow faster and we'd all be smarter.
Describe a pizza and tell us how you were like each ingredient.
Okay, so I used to work at Papa Murphy's, so this is how it works. You gotta like get the dough out, and I'm like the meat, because I'm a man. And then... What? These are hard questions. Maybe I'm the cheese. Well, I'm everything, so I'm just the bullseye.
If you were a girl, what sports would you play?
First of all, I play volleyball, because my booty would be popping. Second of all, I would play swimming, because my booty would be popping. Third of all, that was the only sports that I would play.
Did you see the blue and black dress, or the white and gold dress?
Trick question. I looked past the dress into her soul, because women shouldn't be objectified by what they wear.
Since like 2009, so...
Pop music. Can you sing a bit for us?
I'm in a club, but why would I who would it be?
Oh man. Probably Kim, just to hear what Kanye says. I mean, could you imagine? I wonder what kind of names he says, like, for babies, you know? Like, name me.
Hey guys, this means a lot to me. Not because, you know, it's an amazing feat to accomplish a whole run, it's amazing, but I have a condition called asthma. It makes it really hard to breathe in, you know? So I go to professional, like, breathing competitions, I hold my breath, and some people say it's, like, illegal to use an inhaler. I'm going to right now. My previous record with an inhaler is 30 seconds, so if I can get a timer somewhere, it's all right, we got a timer, it's all right. So I'm just gonna, you know, 178 puffs left, so. Try me. Come on. Breathe. Come on. Am I breathing? Can you hear it? Can you hear it?
No.
Where am I at?
21 seconds.
Let's go. This is my first time. Done it before.
Just reached 30.
What do you think? Thank you. Okay, I'm done. What's the time?
43 seconds.
Let's go! 43! I'll be back here again. I'll put up signs, you know, for my next performance. You guys just go. Thank you so much.
Next up is senior Jim Barnett. Jim will be playing a classic tune on the xylophone.
We all live in the yellow submarine. Yellow submarine.
If you were a color, what would you be and why?
I'd say yellow because it's kind of like a stereotype, like Asians are yellow.
How do you explain it?
It's like the skin color of everyone in America, except people not white. Stop!
Which contestant do you not want to win?
Derek Lifeman. He owes me $40.
Which celebrity crush and why?
I'd have to go with my boy Jay Beebs. I'd like to make it some romance for a little bit. What is going on?
Survive a shipwreck anyway. Bob Gill, he's got pretty sweet hair, but he needs computers to do things well. You know, he's good with computers, so I don't think he's going to be the computers involved in a shipwreck. So obviously, I'd have to go with Mr. Mick because he's a genius, so he'll help me survive.
If you won, what would you do with your $100?
I would get Elena back because she'll obviously want me because I've got $100 and a sweet crown. And then I would take her out to get some ice cream at Zesto because she works there and she'll get it for free. And then I'll keep the rest of the money.
We have senior Garrett Biscara doing an acrobatic martial arts performance. What's your idea of a perfect date?
April 25th, because it's not too hot, not too cold, all you need is a light jacket.
Coke or Pepsi?
Pepsi, I don't do drugs.
We can come think about it. Can you sing a little bit for us? Like,
my best friend gave me the best advice.
Hello. I shall be breaking some wood, chopping some wood. Here's my assistant, Everson. Konnichiwa Suzuki Toyota, Everest-san.
center stage. First contestant moving on is Alan Garcia.
The second contestant moving on is Daniel Ellis.
Our third contestant is Derek Lightman.
Our final contestant moving on is Peter Sanchez.
Congratulations to the four contestants moving on. I would like to take this time to thank you four boys that will not be moving on to the next round. These boys worked hard in preparation for tonight. You all need extraordinary class and courage. At this time, please take a spell very decorated. Thank you.
Congratulations to these four boys left on stage. Please stay on stage for our next category. We will now choose four women from the audience to come up on stage.
I choose Blaine Holm.
Marcella?
Yeah, Marcella!
Is Megan Keith here?
No,
did she leave? Come up here.
Come on, girls. We need some girls.
I don't know, Maggie.
Woo! Olivia Bertram.
Olivia, let's go!
There. Get gone!
And Lily Sanchez.
Oh,
Lily's not here. Never mind.
Back on Mock.
Becca, come on up.
And Connie Hone, yeah!
So now that we can pick up lines on these four girls over here.
And if you want to volunteer to go first? All right, Peter. Becca, go ahead.
No, I want myself.
Weird.
This is a family event. Hey, Becca, do you work at Starbucks? Because I like you a lot.
I like you at Starbucks.
Anyone else on here?
Bring him to center stage. Yeah.
All right, Daniel. Daniel. Wait, sit down. Marcella.
Oh, I'm sorry, it looks like I'm falling for you.
Alan?
No.
Do you like sales? Because pants are 100% off at my house.
Okay, we have the final two contestants. The two contestants that will be moving on in hopes of becoming Mr. PHS are Derek. Derek Leiperman, my bad. And Alan Garcia.
Tonight and competing. The scores were tight and you're both so close to moving on, but they were closer. Give it up for these two handsome men tonight.
To top the night off, we will have a bucket run. Put money in the bucket of the person you want to give 5 extra points added to their overall score. All proceeds go to Children's Miracle Network.
Open your hearts.
Which color is Alan?
Alan's red, Derek is green.
Alan will be red and Derek will be green.
Right, hold that. Make him run around. Make him run around with it.
Okay.
Alan.
I'm gonna go.
Hold on, 1 second. We're gonna time you.
Derek, you go to the.
So we're separated by 4 points. So whoever wins this one,
should we tell them that?
Huh?
Okay, you will have 60 seconds starting now.
Mason, they're separated by 4 points, so this is important.
They're separated by only 4 points. This is really important. Before we announce the winner, we would like to say thank you. Thank both of you for entertaining the crowd this evening. Also, thanks to our judges for taking the time to participate. Thank you to our tech guy, Tim Kirkpatrick. Woo! And a huge thank you to our Student Senate advisors, Brittany Green and Bob Gill. Also to the rest of the Student Senate members for making this night possible. Lastly, thank you to you guys for showing up. We appreciate it so much. And the cameraman.
Drum roll, please. Your 2016 Mr. PHS is Alan Garcia.
Thank you all for coming. Candidates will now be available for photos. Have a wonderful rest of your evening.
This little hobby. That one.
I got you, baby.
Street. When I start to dance, everything goes chick, chicky, boom, chick, chicky, boom.
The senoritas they sing and they swing with their amero. It's very nice, so full of fine. And when they're dancing, they bring a happy ring to that aquero. Singing a song all the day long. So, if you like the beat, take a lesson from Cuban Pete. And that teaches you to chick chicky boom, chick chicky boom, chick chicky boom. Senorita, I know that you would like a cheeky boom chick. It's very nice, so full of spice.
I'll place my hand on your hip, and if you will just give me your hand,
that we shall try, just you and I.
Hey!
Let's rock this!